Every hockey player's dream is to make the NHL regardless of what it takes. The journey is never easy, but opportunity is only granted to those who put forth the effort and display great character. Athletes will always be criticized and always analyzed. Everyone often praises the taller athletes and tend to overshadow the smaller, grittier ones.
No one expects David to overcome Goliath, but a native of Laval, Canada, was poised to take down Goliath and overcome every stereotype thrown his way.
Born in June of 1975, Martin St.Louis was always smaller than his teammates. Registering at 5'9", St.Louis had an impressive college career, being convinced to attend the University of Vermont and join the Canamounts. In his first season, he'd notched 51 points in 33 games. In his second year, however, St.Louis would make an even bigger impact. His game-winning goal would help the Canamounts reach the Final Four. However, they'd eventually lose 4-3 in double overtime. St.Louis would be nominated twice for the Hobey Baker Award, and this attracted many NHL teams who tried to convince St.Louis to leave Vermont and go pro. However, he decided to stay one more year. His stats would fall off a bit, but he would eventually finish his time in Vermont as being the team's all-time leading scorer. The NHL offers would eventually fade away and teams lost interest. The Senators would offer him a professional tryout, but it wouldn't last long. St. Louis went to the IHL, scoring 50 points in 56 games, and this attracted the Calgary Flames, who would seek interest and sign St. Louis. He would play in the AHL for a year, but finally got his call-up. And being paired with Fleury, St. Louis had an opportunity to shine. However, just games after being put in the lineup, St. Louis would find himself a healthy scratch and sitting out of numerous games. St. Louis would go back and forth from the AHL and the NHL, but after the Flames exposed him in the expansion draft and no one grabbed him, the Flames decided to buy out his contract. The Lightning decided to give him a chance, and St. Louis, now knowing his career was at stake, decided to trust his gut and play by his own morals. Blocking out what the coaches told him was the way to play. After struggling in his first two seasons, something in St. Louis snapped, and he went off.
St. Louis beating on a shield. Thanks. Shoot. Score!
In the 2002-2003 season, St. Louis showed why he deserved a second chance. Tying Vinny LeCavalier for the team leading 33 goals and finished 4th best in scoring, he also took part in his first All-Star game, winning the puck control relay event. And St. Louis wasn't done yet, as the following season, he'd capture the Art Ross Trophy as the league's leading goal scorer, producing 94 points. However, not only would St. Louis show his worth that season, he'd show one team that they've made a huge mistake. 2004, Stanley Cup Final. The Lightning just finished knocking off the Flyers in the Eastern Conference Final and were on an impressive run. However, their opponents also went on a run for the ages, as the Calgary Flames just took down the San Jose Sharks. This matchup was not just crucial for both teams, but for the now Tampa Bay star, St. Louis, who now has to prove his former team that they were foolish for not believing in him. Game 6. Flames lead the series 3-2. They win, and it's over. And after a controversial missed call by the refs, which would have made Martin Gelinas a household name, the Lightning still had a chance to shift momentum. The Lightning had the puck, and put it on the stick of the former Calgary Flame.
Did up the wall, Calamar went down, Taylor the shot, redirected, score! Game 7! St. Louis! We are going back to Tampa Bay!
After scoring this goal, the whole dynamic of the series was changed. The Lightning had new life. They had a new spark, and in Game 7 would grasp the cup. St. Louis was now a Stanley Cup champion and showed the entire world and his former team that he had what it takes to win a championship. He got his revenge on his former club and gained confidence in his game. St. Louis would only go up from there, eventually posting his first 100-point season and playing in his 500th NHL game. He would also become the first Lightning player to take part in 3 All-Star games. And in the 2012-13 season, he was named the Lightning's 9th captain in franchise history, receiving high praise from general manager Steve Yzerman. Everything for St. Louis was going great. In January of 2014, St. Louis requested a trade from Tampa Bay and was shipped off to the Rangers, where, once again, he'd experience a cup run of the ages. The Rangers' main focus was around St. Louis. They wanted to give him one last cup. After coming back from a 3-1 series hole, it would help create a path to the 2014 Stanley Cup Final. But St. Louis would unfortunately have the experience of being on the losing side of the ice after Alex Martinez would make one of the most memorable plays in Stanley Cup Final history.
Back up with it now is Martinez in a 3-on-2. Clifford gave it across. It's held in a shot. Safe. Rebound. Score! The Stanley Cup Martinez!
The Rangers would fall to the Kings, who had a season to remember, and the following season, they would fall short of making a return as the Rangers fell to St. Louis' former team. The Rangers wouldn't extend St. Louis and let him go to the free agent market. St. Louis would then retire from hockey. However, his legacy wasn't over yet. In 2018, he was inducted to the Hockey Hall of Fame, and his speech was an emotional one. He had teammates from both the Lightning and the Rangers come to watch him get inducted in. He will now forever be remembered in hockey history. The story of St. Louis is a special one. It shows that no matter what is said, hard work pays off. He had low expectations, and no one seemed to want him to help succeed. Everyone deserves a chance to prove their worth, and the Lightning saw potential. Hard work pays off. Things will always be said that can try to put one down, but it's what that person does with those words that define who they are. St. Louis didn't let them get to him. He stuck by his morals and his beliefs. He believed in himself and his teammates, and now will be forever remembered as one of hockey's greatest players and one of the biggest underdogs of all time.